Fujifilm has surprised us all with a bunch of camera and lens release news recently. And the good news is, Fujifilm has launched the second version of one of its most popular APS-C cameras, the X-T30. So what changes will be there in the Fujifilm X-T30 Mark II? Has it fixed all of the major issues we have faced in the X-T30? And most importantly, is it worth buying? All these are going to be discussed in this video. So with that being said, let's get started. The Fujifilm X-T30 Mark II comes with a 26.1 megapixel APS-C CMOS sensor, the same as its predecessor, the X-T30. But on the bright side, there are two additional film simulations in the newer version, the Classic Negative and the Eterna Bleach Bypass. These two simulations have been taken from the more advanced X-T4. Additionally, there is also a bit of change in the color chrome effect, as the X-T30 Mark II has a blue color chrome effect. One of the cool features that we have seen in the X-T30 is the grain effect. You can change the intensity of that effect. But with the new Mark II version, you can now change the grain size as well as the intensity. As for the image format, the X-T30 Mark II can capture images in both RAW and JPEG, but there is no confirmed news about the RAW plus JPEG shooting. In addition to that, the video capabilities of this camera are almost the same as X-T30, as both the cameras can shoot UHD or DCI 4K at 30 frames per second. But if you're shooting for slow motion videos, the X-T30 Mark II has a slight edge over its previous version, as it can shoot 1080p at 240 frames per second compared to the 1080p 120fps of the X-T30. Apart from that, the body is still the same as the X-T30. However, we were expecting that version 2 would come with a weather seal feature, but it didn't, which is a little disappointing. About the autofocus, this camera features the 425 points phase detection autofocus, which is also the same as its predecessor. But the performance of the X-T30 Mark II is slightly better, as it inherits the high-speed autofocus of the flagship X-T4 and can focus on a subject in just 0.02 seconds. Moreover, the low-light performance has also been improved. This camera can detect subjects in as low light as a minus 7 exposure value, where the X-T30 could detect the lowest of minus 3 exposure value. However, there is no in-body image stabilization like its previous version. Another differentiating point of the X-T30 Mark II is the LCD screen. Though the screen has the same 3.2 inch size, the resolution has been improved to 1.62 million dots, which was 1.04 million dots in the X-T30. The X-T30 Mark II comes with an NPW126S battery, which can shoot 390 images or 45 minutes of video per charge. The camera can also be charged using the USB Type-C 3.2 Gen port. So that was all the major changes and features that we have found in the Fujifilm X-T30 version 2. Now let's discuss the price. The X-T30 will cost you about $800, while version 2 has a price tag of $900. And now, the most vital question, is it worth it? And the answer is, yes. It's just $100, and with that additional bucks, you're getting improved autofocus and low light performance, more frames when you're shooting slow motion, and so on. So our recommendation is, if you already have an X-T30, you probably don't need to upgrade to the Mark II version. But if you're planning to buy a Fujifilm APS-C camera for less than $1,000, we would suggest you to go for the X-T30 Mark II. So what is your opinion on the Fujifilm X-T30 Mark II? Let us know in the comments section.